So Leute, da sind wir wieder. Heute in Advance Wars Dual Strike. Und es ist Absicht, dass meine Maus hier im Bild ist. Die brauche ich nämlich für dieses Spiel leider. Weil ich habe dummerweise keine hundertprozentig funktionierende ROM für dieses Spiel. Denn ich sehe, sofern ich im Spiel selbst drin bin, den Cursor leider nicht. Das heißt, ich muss das alles über Touchscreen bedienen, was Gott sei Dank natürlich geht. Und wie angekündigt, das ganze Spiel wird auf Englisch gespielt. Und ich hoffe, ihr könnt mir das mit meinem Hintergrund momentan noch ein bisschen verzeihen. Ich habe den halt immer noch so, wie ich ihn vom Pokémon aufnehmen vorhin eben hatte. Ich werde mal schauen, ob ich für die Zukunft vielleicht einen Advance Wars lastigeren Hintergrund nehmen werde. Ansonsten würde ich sagen, wir starten jetzt erstmal die Kampagne und ja, schauen mal, was dieses Spiel für uns jetzt Neues bereithält. Ich kenne sie ja schon, also ich habe die Teile alle durchgespielt, aber vielleicht hat es eine oder andere von euch noch nicht gesehen. Also, viel Spaß bei der Kampagne. Ich lese jetzt sowieso erstmal wieder einen Haufen Dialoge, nur dass ich das diesmal alles auf Englisch machen muss. Ich weiß immer noch nicht, ob das eine gute Idee war, aber ich hoffe mal ja. Vor allem mit den ganzen Stimmen, das Ganze jetzt noch auf Englisch vorzulesen. Oh, das ist schwierig. Several months have passed since the war in Makroland, thanks to Andy Nell and the other cause to the Black Hole Army was defeated. The people there can finally live in peace. But in the far-off continent of Onmegaland, trouble was brewing. It's from here that Black Hole has launched a massive invasion. The enemy army has replenished its might with remarkable speed under the command of a new leader. The last Great War left many questions unanswered, and so Orange Star, Blue Moon, Green Earth and Yellow Comet have joined forces to create the Allied Nations, determined to free their homeland and launch a counterattack. So, ich hoffe, ihr habt das alles verstanden. Wenn nicht, sagt bitte Bescheid, damit ich euch solche Sachen in Zukunft übersetzen werde. Oder zumindest grob übersetzen werde. Ich gehe mal hoffentlich davon aus, dass ein Großteil meiner Zuschauer so weit Englisch kann, dass ihr das alles noch versteht. Rachel, I want to be careful. This looks like it could be a tough battle. Don't you worry me, sis. You've got our hands full over in Makroland. We may not have a big presence here in Omegaland, but we're not alone. With all four island nations working together, Black Hole is no match for us. I'm glad to hear that. Still, I've sent a few of our crews to give you a hand. Just hang in there until they can arrive. And don't do anything rash, okay? I've got it, sis. My Omegaland crews can take anything Black Hole dishes out. I know. And with you in the field, I got nothing to worry about. I don't think I'll be able to join you though. That means you're in charge of field training and any new course, alright? Got it. Good, thanks. Good, that's all, soldier. And by the way, don't call me sis, not when the other course might hear. Oh yeah, that might get them wondering about your age. Hey, that's not what I'm saying at all. I have my orders, Commander Nell. I'll take care of everything. Rachel's signing out. So, Commander Nell is your sister? Yep, we both enlisted about the same time, but it's my big... Commander Nell's smarter than me, and she rose through the ranks fast. Luck had something to do with it, too. Ah, you're razor sharp, Rachel. I guess I haven't been much of anywhere, but I haven't met anyone smarter. Huh, take one step out of Omegaland and you'll be tripping over coast with way more skill than me. But listen, Jake, Omegaland is a very real danger, and we can't count on getting back up from Makroland anytime soon. We can't even be sure where all of our allied coasts are now either. You and me are the only ones left to stop the enemy, Jake. Sounds like our backs are up against the wall. All in all, you're taking this pretty well. You are not worried? Nah, well, yeah, maybe a little. But with you rolling beside me, I know it's all good. Don't even think I'm doing all the work. You're going to have to pull your weight. It's time to start training. I'm warning you, though, I'm not going easy on you. What? Oh, let me turn the music down. Yeah, cool, I'm listening. Das ist übrigens auch der Grund, warum ich das Ganze auf Englisch spielen will. Die Dialoge sind auf Englisch viel besser als auf Deutsch. Und Jake hat die beste Musik ever. The orange units on the map are yours, Jake. The blue units are mine. They are on special loan from Blue Moon's army. The real enemy is Black Hole, so their units will be black. Don't forget, this moving triangle is the cursor. You'll use it to give orders to your units. Tap one of your units and you issue an order, Jake. Cool, I give it a shot. So, an dieser Stelle brauche ich die Maus, weil ich kann meinen Cursor zwar überall irgendwo hin bewegen, aber ich weiß nicht genau, wo der gerade ist. The unit you select is a mech unit. It's a direct combat unit. That means it needs to be next to an opponent to attack. It has the firepower to challenge a tank unit, something infantry units can't do. However, it will take heavy damage if it gets attacked. You'll want to strike first to avoid being wiped out. When you select the unit, an area around the unit's color... The unit changes color like this. Blah. You're looking at this unit's movement range. Tap where you want to move to. Then select either attack or wait to finish moving. Tap cancel to receive the order. So. That's a tank unit, a direct combat unit that must be next to an enemy to attack. Tanks have great speed and firepower, so I'm sure you'll be using them often. So. Oh, dazu fällt mir jetzt gleich wieder ein, dass ich da noch ein bisschen was wieder umstellen muss. Und der laggt hier manchmal ein bisschen. Da. The unit you selected is an infantry unit. It's a direct combat unit. In addition to attacking infantry and mech units, it can also capture cities and bases. There's a white city and an orange city near your infantry, right? The orange city is one of your bases, that means it's under your control. The white city is a neutral city, it's not under any army's control. Why would I want to capture a city like this? Good question, if you capture a city, you earn funds from it every day. Also, resting a unit on a base restores some of its hit points, ammo and fuels each day. Wow, that's cool, so capturing enemy cities must be pretty important then. You've got it right. Taking control of an enemy property is still a solid strategy. You've started capturing, haven't you? Check out the dark window in the corner. This is called the cursor window. That flashing number is the capture number. Once that number hits zero, the property you're securing is captured. And an undamaged unit with 10 hit points can reduce a capture number by 10 each day. So, at best, capturing a property will take you 2 days. And while we're on the subject, you shouldn't move a unit while it's capturing. If you forget and move, the property's capture number will return to full. It's the same is true if the unit is defeated, so be sure to defend the capturing unit. Oh, and another thing, see the three next to the star icon? That's the terrain bonus. The higher the number, the better the defense it gives. The max is 5, so 3 is pretty good. When you've given commands to all units, tap the menu button shown above. This opens the map menu. At the bottom of the menu is an end command. Select this to finish your turn. Once you do that, the enemy's turn will begin. Then it'll be your turn to attack, right? Yep, and even though it's training, I'm not going easy on you. So, wir hatten jetzt genug von Shakes Team. Jetzt dürfen wir Rachel mal dran lassen. We're on day 2. To win this exercise, you need to defeat all my units. I've taught you the basics of combat, so feel free to move however you want. If you want to know more about a unit or terrain type, tap it and move the cursor. Then check the top screen to see in-depth intelligence. Don't forget, get ready to roll and don't you dare to hold back. I'll know if you're going easy on me. Alright, I won't pull any punches. So... Ganz genau, so fertig besetzen. Ich habe euch noch gar nicht erzählt, was Jake alles kann, ne? Jake ist prinzipiell ähnlich wie Andy. Er hat keine großartigen Stärken oder Schwächen, bis auf die eine Sache, dass wenn er von einer Ebene aus angreift, dass er 10% mehr Schaden macht. Und da Ebenen ein relativ häufiges Terrain ist, sag ich mal, ist das eigentlich gar nicht so schlecht. Rachel hat ebenfalls eine besondere Fähigkeit, aber zu Rachel komme ich, sobald wir sie selbst spielen. Denn momentan ist ihre Fähigkeit noch nicht von Belang. Oh, es kann sein, dass ich einen Schnupfen kriege demnächst. You beat me. Not bad. You may be young, but you've definitely got what it takes to be a great co. You were born for the battlefield. Yeah, you think so? Sweet, that means something coming from you yet, Rachel. You've got good instincts, I'm going to personally make you one of the best. There are going to be some tough times ahead, so just stick with me. You know I will. Da haben wir natürlich auch unseren ersten S-Rang. Und das ist auch so eine kleine Neuerung. Die Kurs hier können Ränge aufsteigen von 0 bis 100, wobei eigentlich nur bis 10 wirklich Sinn macht. Get the plates, cause you just got served. Das mag ich an Jake. Er redet immer so schön umgangssprachlich. So, speichern wir einfach mal. Commander Rachel, we've encountered advanced enemy forces. Understood, we'll head to the battlefield right away. Have you taken casualties? Our infantry has taken sporadic fire, but the enemy force is fairly small. I see, well, we've got to get in there and rescue those grunts. So I heard some Black Hole forces wanna rumble? Yes, they've progressed much farther and faster than I'd anticipated. I'd hope to get some more training and but you have to play with what you're dealt. Yeah, but there aren't many enemy units. Just kick back and give me some tips while I mop these guys up. That's the spirit, Jake. Sounds like we've got ourselves a plan. Okay, move out. Manchmal gar nicht so einfach, das Ganze flüssig zu lesen. Mission 2, the new black. Allied forces falling back. Yes, sir. We've captured the nearby headquarters. Our conquest of Omega Land will be If we capture the nearby headquarters, our conquest of Omega Land will be complete. The enemy resistance has been pathetic, hasn't it, Commander Jagger? Query, are we inside Iron Star territory? Looks like it, sir. Purge enemy from memory. Understood. The enemy has three tank units. You'd better rest your infantry on that city. Those guys aren't going to last long unless we get there fast. It's all good, I'll send my tank to rescue them. Wah wah wah! I know you're hard to beat when you're on the plains, but you've only got one tank unit, so you can't win a head-on-head attack. You must destroy every tank unit, and you'll lose if your infantry falls. You've got new units to try out, so let's put them to work. Go ahead and select a unit. Yeah, wir haben hier Artillerie-Einheiten. That's an artillery unit. If it doesn't move, it can't bombard enemies from afar. It's deployed in a good strategic location right now. Isn't our army well trained? in direct combat. Cool, does that mean I can't hit those tanks across the river? Yep, and because it's over here, you don't have to worry any about counterattacks. But if an artillery unit is attacked directly, it can't fight back. It'll be a pile of slack in short order, so don't leave it exposed. To attack, touch the unit and choose fire from the menu. Always keep in mind that artillery units can't move and fire in the same turn. If there aren't enemy units in range, the fire command will not be available. To see a unit range fire, touch and hold the unit for a few seconds. You can use the same technique to check the firing range of other units. Alright, I give it a shot. Was sie damit gemeint hat, Moment mal. Wenn ich die Einheit so antippe und ein bisschen drauf bleibe, dann sehe ich hier wieder die Reichweite. Und im Moment haben wir diesen Jagdpanzer in Reichweite. So, den bewegen wir hier hin. Und den. This unit is in a rough shape. It needs time to recover, that's for sure. But leaving it here could be dangerous. This is where APCs come in handy. Those things can carry infantry and mech units, right? Yep, and as long as the APC doesn't get destroyed, they will be safe. Plus, APCs have movement range of 6, allowing them to get off the front easily. Select the infantry unit and move it onto the APC, then select Lord from the menu. If the APC is in range, order the infantry to load it up. Oh, you got it. I'll make sure those grunts get back safely. You've got the right idea, I'm counting on you. Ja, kann man machen, muss man aber nicht. This is an APC, a non-combat unit. It's designed to transport infantry and deliver supplies to adjacent units. By supplies, I mean APC replenish unit fuel and ammo reserves. They can supply up to 4 units at once as long as the units are adjacent spaces. Schwieriges Wort hier. Plus, it doesn't matter if the units are land, sea or air units. Nice, right? Once a unit loads onto an APC, the drop command will appear in the command menu. After that, it's as simple as choosing where you want to unload the unit. It couldn't be easier, really. I get it. In these missions I have to protect my infantry, so the APC is essential. Exactly. You know what APCs can... You know that APCs can't move in mountains though, right? That's because they run on threat and treats, just like tanks. Units with treats also get slowed down a bit when moving through wooded areas. Be sure to check out the top screen for more details on terrain types. So, den stelle ich jetzt dahin. Und dann lassen wir den Chugger mal dran sein. Chugger ist mehr oder weniger der Helmut-Ersatz, wenn ich das mal so sagen darf. Er ist wie Helmut. Command Chugger, enemy unit spotted. Identify enemy commander. He is a young guy. Profile matched. Andy of Orange Star. No sir, it doesn't seem to be him. Hey, Black Hole Chumps. You think you're all bad stealing people's stuff? File not found, you're an Orange Star cow. You know it, now answer me. Reply irrelevant, reserving energy for current tasks, splitting you like an atom. You're in Orange Star's house now, you're going down. Attack, attack, attack. Ja, Chugger, ein süßer kleiner Roboter, der mehr oder weniger dasselbe kann wie Helmut, nur ein bisschen extremer. Er hat nämlich bis zu 30% mehr Glück, dafür bis zu 15% mehr Unglück. Helmut wurde dementsprechend etwas gebufft. Er hat nämlich jetzt plus 25, minus 10. Er ist damit nicht mehr der schwächste Co. im Spiel. Und Helmut kommt in der Kampagne übrigens auch nicht mal vor. Der wurde hier mehr oder weniger komplett von Chugger ersetzt. Und Helmut heißt auch gar nicht mehr Helmut, weil wir spielen ja jetzt die englische Version. Da heißt der Flag. Das ist nämlich Helmuts englischer Name. sollte es einfach machen, da wir vor allem auf der Ebene sind. Das ist ja Jakes Spezialgebiet. Woohoo! I mean, very well done. That was excellent work, Jake. Rock on, I won. I knew you'd deliver. You're going to be a great coach, Jake. So, you're Black Hole Goods, huh? Don't you guys ever give up? And how did you recover so quickly? Last I checked, your armies were trashed after your last failed invasion. Reply irrelevant. Initiating Chaga retreat protocol. Next time Chaga breaks you. What are they after? Who knows, but they're out in force and bent to destruction, that's for sure. Let's leave the intelligence gathering to the props and focus on the fighting. Yeah, we've got to drop these fools. That's right, let's take it to them. Rock! Da haben wir einen nächsten Ex-Rang. Owned.